Hi guys, so I'm here to give my final thoughts on the very last Star Trek series that has been broadcast to date, Star Trek Enterprise. I think the biggest problem that most people had with this series is the fact that it takes place before everything that's happened. And although prequels can work, I don't think people really wanted to know how the United Federation of Planets came to be. Also, I don't think the casting characters were well-developed enough to take on a series like Star Trek. Now, don't get me wrong. You got a Vulcan, you've got new aliens that no one's ever heard of, and you've got a human captain. I understand. That's the formula, and it's worked. But the problem is, these characters simply don't resonate the way that even Voyager, and I'm not even a fan of Voyager, but even Voyager characters have resonated with the Star Trek continuity, with the community, the people who watch. These characters, unfortunately, are not spoken in warm reception from when they aired, and even afterwards. Another problem that a lot of people have with this series, me included, is the fact that they screw up the timeline with a lot of the things they do, like seeing the Borg. Like, what's another example? There's a lot of stuff that goes on that doesn't make any sense, because there's a big chance to screw up a lot of what comes later based on this. And on top of that, this is going to make me sound kind of petty, but Captain Archer is honestly one of the weakest, if not the weakest, captains in any of the Star Trek series that I've seen. I'm sure he's a decent actor, and yes, he is famous from other shows, but as far as being a Star Trek captain, he just isn't very good. And ultimately, in a show like this, if the captain isn't good, your series is going to suffer as a result. So those are my thoughts. I'll see you guys later, and we'll move on to the next reviewer.
I've said this a couple times about some of the series that we've come across, Voyager being the ultimate example of this. But when it comes to Enterprise, you can really see what they were trying to do. But the problem was Enterprise comes off as kind of like the little sibling to the rest of the Star Trek series, saying, look at how cool I am, and taking aspects from those series to try and make itself better. You can't just place the Borg in an episode hoping to borrow the same success that you have with Next Generation. You can't just throw some Klingons on, and while, yes, that was what saved the episode that we saw, for the most part, if those Klingons don't look like they did in the original series, then you're starting to wonder why they may even bother to try and explain away why the Klingons in the original series weren't ridged. It comes trying too hard to create a series that recaptures the glory of the original series and keep what was working for you in Next Generation. It's too much. It's just too much. Based on this being the last Star Trek series, I would like to just take a brief moment to speculate on the future. Do I think that there's a potential for new series to happen? Sure, I'd love to see new series in a little bit of a future time. Maybe getting closer to what's been covered in the online game, where the Klingon Empire and the Federation have a gun split paths and now are at war again. Maybe a series spent in that time during the same continuity would be interesting. But this is all just speculation. So, let's move on.